To solve this equation, I'm going to use substitution. The key to substitution is the middle term, so I'm going to let u equal x to the minus 1 power. So then u squared would be x to the minus 1 power squared. Power to power, you multiply. Negative 1 times 2 is negative 2. So x to the minus 2 is equal to u squared. That's what we have here. So making that substitution, I'll be left with u squared minus u minus 1 equals 0. So you could see this is a regular old quadratic. Turns out, though, this one's not going to factor. So let's use the quadratic formula. A is 1, b is negative 1, and c is negative 1. Using the quadratic formula, notice here my variable is u, so u equals negative b plus or minus b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. Let's go ahead and plug in. So negative b, negative negative 1 plus or minus the square root negative 1 squared minus 4 times a times c all over 2 times a. A is 1. And then simplifying, we'd be left with 1 plus or minus the square root negative 1 squared is 1 plus 4 all over 2. Okay, and negative 4 times a 1 times a negative 1 is positive 4. Or 1 plus or minus the square root of 5 all over 2. Okay, so here we got two solutions for u. U could equal 1 minus the square root of 5 over 2, or u could equal 1 plus the square root of 5 over 2. Two solutions for u, but we're solving for x. Let's remember x equals, or x to the negative 1 equals u. So when we make that back substitution, u equals x to the negative 1 like that. Okay, so that should equal 1 minus square root of 5 over 2. Or again, back substituting x to the minus 1 should equal 1 plus square root of 5 over 2. Now we have to solve each one of these. Remember, x to the negative 1 power is the same thing as 1 over x. So we can write that as 1 over x equals 1 minus square root of 5 over 2. Or 1 over x could also equal 1 plus square root of 5 over 2. Okay, at this point we can cross multiply and then solve for x, but I'm going to show you a little bit of a trick. Whenever you have a fraction equals a fraction, you can reciprocate both sides. So x over 1 should equal 2 over 1 minus square root of 5. Also, x over 1 could equal 2 over 1 plus square root of 5. That's just reciprocating both sides. Now, the solutions in the back of the book probably have the answers rationalized. You can't have radicals in the denominator. So to do that, if you remember, what we're going to do here is multiply numerator and denominator by the conjugate here, 1 plus square root of 5. Same thing on this one. The conjugate, though, would be 1 minus square root of 5. Okay, so let's simplify these. That then says x equals 2 times 1 plus square root of 5 all over. When you multiply these together, 1 times 1 is 1. The middle terms are going to cancel. And then negative square root of 5 times square root of 5 is minus 5. And then over here we'll be left with 2 over 1 minus square root of 5, over 1, again, minus 5. So we can simplify these a little more. 2 times 1 plus square root of 5 all over here. 1 minus 5 is negative 4. Same thing here. 1 minus square root of 5. 2 times 1 minus square root of 5 over negative 4. And then we can cancel, it looks like. For our final answer, we would have 1 plus square root of 5 over negative 2. Right? 2's would cancel. And then here we have 1 minus square root of 5 over 2. Okay, so cleaning this up a little further then, x would be equal to negative 1 half minus square root of 5 over 2, or x would be equal to 1 half, whoops, sorry, that should be negative. So negative 1 half plus square root of 5 over 2. So in the back of the book you might see the two solutions expressed in set notation, negative 1 half plus or minus the square root of 5 over 2. So there's my two solutions to the original using u-substitution.